Mm-hmm. Hi, Rog. Welcome to the show. Meet Billy, Roger. That was very good, Billy. Do you want to carry on for a bit, or...? No, you got to go, actually. We're over time. But thanks a lot, though. Thanks a lot. That was brilliant. Well done, my friend. So, Rog, it's nice to see the kids doing the thing, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. I can...
When did you start? You started early, didn't you?
Yeah, I don't think he remembers us starting, no. Yeah.
When did you actually start?
What, playing?
Yeah, just playing instruments.
I don't know, I suppose I started drums about 12, but I sort of tried to play the ukulele at about 8 or something.
That was your first instrument, the ukulele?
Sort of.
If only we had a ukulele here tonight, then. And we have. Can you give us a burst on it? Can you still do it?
Well, you see, I had this... my own technique, which didn't involve knowing what chords were.
All right.
So I used to play... I don't think it's in tune. That's it.
And you too could be a rock star.
Takes that much talent.
So you are a rock star, aren't you?
Oh, not really, no.
Yes, you are. You're a worldwide rock star. What's it
Excellent.
Like?
I thought the easy ones were going to come later. No, no, the difficult one. I don't know how to answer that, really. I'm just a musician, really.
OK, well, let's put you in the mood. Let's look at Roger being a rock star, a proper rock star. Another one bites the dust. She's a killer queen. Gunpowder, gelatine. Dynamite with a laser beam. Guaranteed to blow your mind. It's a hard life. To be true lovers together. To love and live forever in each other's hearts. Which was your favourite look out of all the looks over the years?
I like the one at washing the dishes.
Yeah, you like that one. And what kind of ticket does it buy you, being a rock star?
ticket?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's a good living. It's a good living. Yeah.
But I mean, you know,
we scraped by.
What's the best bit? Is it the work? Is it the life? Is it the girls? Is it the cars? Is it the houses? What is it?
All of that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
and out of all of you, who rocked it up most? Was it? Because I think it's a toss between you and Freddie.
Well, I think you're probably right. We were the absolute shockers.
Yeah.
And, but I think we went in sort of slightly different ways, but we'd usually meet at the end of the evening.
OK, I know what you're saying. I don't know what you're saying, but I can guess. Let's ask you, are these true, some facts about you? I've been reading all the stuff all week. You were the first major rock group to tour South America, and the response was tremendous, but your single Under Pressure was number one in Argentina throughout the Falklands War.
I think that's right, actually. We'd just come back from there, you see, and they started the war conveniently the week after.
After you came back?
Yeah.
You didn't have anything to do with starting it, I hope, did you?
It probably didn't help, yeah.
What's this about your parties? Queen's parties were notorious, true or false? Stories of strippers?
Yeah.
Yes. OK. Transvestites?
Yeah.
Now, what, snake charmers at your parties?
Yeah.
OK. Hawkers.
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Does it say about the man who used to move under meat for a living?
Move under meat?
Yeah, he used to...
No, it doesn't.
Well, never mind.
Okay, all right then. What does that mean? And at one photo shoot, 60 women riding naked on bicycles around Wimbledon.
Yeah.
All that's true.
Yeah, I actually wasn't there at that one. It's to my great regret.
Is life dull now then, or do you still do? You know, you still get up to mischief?
No, I don't know about that. A bit old for that, but no, life's very full.
Yeah,
very enjoyable.
I went to your house recently. Thank you very much for inviting me. And I said, "What's the most fun you've had here?" And you said, "I can't tell you."
I'm certainly not going to now then.
But was it to do? Was it because it's private, or because it's sexual, or illegal?
Probably.
All those things.
Yep.
And at your house, you have your recording studio.
Yes, I do.
And is that where the Queen songs were recorded?
No, actually, we did some of the last thing there, the Made in Heaven album. Some of that was done there. But really, it was built mainly after Freddie's death. So we used to record anywhere, really, anywhere we found handy or we liked the look of, you know.
To be a real rock star, is it true that you have to nearly have blown it or have blown it?
I hate that phrase, rock star.
I know, but that's...
Well, I think you're going to be on the edge of sort of really being pathetic all the time, yeah.
What's the closest you came to it?
Oh, you know, just the usual pitfalls, I think. You know, you fall into the usual dangers that some people just go over the edge and can't get back. And
was there ever a time you thought, maybe I've gone too far this time, I don't know any way back here?
Most mornings, actually.
Fantastic. Yeah. So who's the best rock star you've ever met? Is Freddie the best, do you think?
Well, I'm a bit biased. I mean, I loved him dearly, but I'd say one of the most impressive people is probably David Bowie, actually.
Is he good at it?
Yeah, he's good. He's good,
good
he's
at the good, life?
Yeah, he's good.
Can do it.
Yeah, he's
doesn't
good.
Doesn't faze him.
Makes you sick, actually.
Now, the Queen weren't a bad band, were they, really?
I think we were OK.
Yeah, yeah. And obviously, you know, you're renowned as the drummer in Queen. If you could have been the drummer in the Beatles or the Stones, which one would you have chosen?
Well, I mean, the obvious thing is to say the Stones, but I think the Beatles' recorded legacy is just so much... It's so impressive. You know, even the Stones wouldn't touch that, although they're a great live act, you know.
And when you were together with the band, I heard about, there were many rows. Is that true? Is that a
yeah,
true fact?
Yeah, yeah. I think that's an important part of being a band, you know.
Having really big rows.
Yeah, serious.
Were there fist fights? Fights?
Well, almost, yeah. I mean, but tension sort of made... All the best stuff came out of tension, usually. So.
Yeah, and who were the main protagonists? Who were the big fighters? Was it you and Fred? Because I can't imagine Brian May getting his...
You'd be surprised.
Well, I would be surprised. I mean, who had the tantrums? Was it you and Fred?
Well, we had the tantrums, but Brian fought a good war of attrition.
Yeah? Just broke you down, grinded you down. What was the biggest misconception about Queen? Was one.
Yeah, I really don't know, actually. No, I couldn't answer that.
What was the best moment?
Best moment? Well, one of the best moments was definitely Live Aid, I think. And the stuff in South America sticks out, yeah.
You would say they were number one band on Live Aid? I would have said that, wouldn't you?
Yeah,
completely. And as far as your music now is concerned, you've got this song called Nation of Haircuts, which I've seen you do. Now, just give us some of the lyrics out of Nation of Haircuts.
What's that? We don't make ships and we don't make cars.
Yeah.
We look real good hanging out in bars.
Yeah. And so what I'm worried about is you've seen the show and it's the Nation of Haircuts is about the people in the bar here every Friday.
Not this bar. There's a bar down in Nottingham. No.
Are we that bad, do you think, as a nation? Have we become a nation of haircuts?
I think we've been in danger for about 30 years.
That's what the song says, isn't it?
Yes, yes. No, it's a very light sort of amusing...
You sang it with a gnarl when I saw you sing it. Haircuts!
Yeah. Dear, did I mean it?
Oh, now, look, Freddie's watching tonight.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, are you?
I feel he's always there.
Yeah,
somewhere.
Yeah. What would you say to him?
Say, what do you think?
Yeah? All right. And who will he be hanging out with?
God, I know who he'd like to be hanging out with.
Who?
He'd like to be hanging out with Jimmy. And, no, the others aren't dead yet.
Well, Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah, I think Jimi Hendrix and John Lennon.
So that'll be some band they've got going up there.
Yeah, it would actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, do you want to fall down the stairs?
I was waiting for you to ask.
Okay, Roger's now going to fall down the stairs. This is easy. Now, you be careful. Be careful.
Oh, really careful.
Roger wrote Radio Gaga. He's now going to sing Radio Gaga for us. Thank you very much. Roger Taylor, Radio Gaga, a special treat.